Right, this is day two of triangle proportionality. We're going to look at special segments within similar triangles. So all of these triangles we already know are similar. So now we're going to look at special pieces that are inside of them. So with altitudes, anytime we have two similar triangles with the altitudes drawn in, you can set up lovely proportions to solve, actually to solve for the altitudes or to use the altitudes. How you would do that is AD over FJ equals one of the sides over another side. Now here's how I really like to write it that I think it makes more sense. Altitude over altitude equals side over side. Altitude over altitude equals side over side. So if this first triangle's on top, he has to stay on top when you do the side. Okay, just pay attention to that part. Now we also have angle bisectors. Exact same thing. We could do, if we know these two triangles are similar, we can do LP over RT equals KL over QR. Well, what did we really do? We really did angle bisector over angle bisector. Okay, so that's this guy over this guy equals a side over a side. Doesn't matter which sides as long as they are the ones that line up with our similarity statement. The next special segment we have are medians. And it works the exact same way. If we have two similar triangles, we could say CD over YZ equals, let's do AC over WY, which is really, what did we do? We did median over median equals side over side. So you're setting up more proportions, and then we would cross multiply. So let's look at a couple examples. Let's look at this first one. What do we have on this first one? Do we have a special segment? I'm already telling you the triangles are similar, so we're good there. Now, do we have a special segment? Yes. Which special segment do we have? Looks to me like the angles are being cut in half. If we look at our angles, we have lovely congruent marks. So for this one, we would do angle bisector over angle bisector equals side over side. Well, I'm going to put this first triangle that I'm going to make red on the top. So angle bisector would be X on that one. My angle bisector on the second triangle is 8 equals the side of my red that it gives me is 15. The side of the other triangle is 12. Now remember, if you want to make life a little easier, you can simplify. 3 goes into 15 and 12, so I would have 5 over 4. Now cross multiply, x times 4 is 4x. 8 times 5 is 40. Divide both sides by 4, and you get x equals 10. So there's the altitude of the first triangle, or I'm sorry, angle bisector of the first triangle. Now let's look at number 2. What do we have on number 2? Well, I see some, I see some angles marked. Those angles marked are not the angles that are being cut in half. Those angles marked are telling us that we have angle, angle, and angle, angle, which means our triangles are similar. What's the line that's going through them? That one doesn't do anything with the angle. It has a 90 degree symbol, which means it's in altitude. So for this one, to set up our fractions, we're going to have altitude over altitude equals side over side. I'm going to put this red triangle on top, the bigger one on top of the fractions. So I'm going to highlight it just to remember that that's my red triangle that's on top. So the altitude of that red triangle is 16. The altitude of the other triangle is X. Now I have to do the side of the first triangle, which the side it gives me is 20, over the side that I'm given on the littler triangle is 15. I like to simplify before I solve because it makes life a little easier. So So I'm going to divide top and bottom by 5 to get 4/3. Now I can cross multiply. 4 times x would be 4x. Now I'm going to go the other way, and I'm going to do 3 times 16 to get 48. Divide each side by 4 to get x equals 12. And that would be the altitude of your second triangle. Try this one. All right, so what do we have on this one? That line that's going through the triangle, it's cutting the opposite side in half, which means we have medians. So what did we say we use for medians? Similar ideas here. Median over median equals side over side. So my median on the top triangle would be 13.5. My median on the bottom triangle is 9. So then I go back to the top triangle. The top triangle shows me x. Then look at the bottom one, and the side that I have for that one is 3. I can't really simplify this one, so we're going to go straight into cross multiplying. Except what's the problem here? Technically, we'd have 2x here and 6 here. But does it make a difference? I'd have 2x, and this would become a 6. Well, simplify that. What happens? I just want to show you this before I keep going on, because someone's going to ask this question. Simplify that. What happens? Divide by 2, you get x on top over 3. Okay, so it's going to do the same thing. So now I'm going to cross multiply. X times 9 would be 9x. Then I'm going to go the other way and do 13.5 times 3 to get 40.5. I'm going to divide that by 9 to get x equals 4.5. Now, that's this little guy. If you ever needed to find that whole side, then it should come out to be 9 because it's a median. It cuts that side in half, so each one would be 4.5, so double it and you get